China is again onto something. What is it? We are currently witnessing a change in the international order, which is being brought by a very tiny deadly virus. But let's talk about this a few days later. But first, let's talk about the battle, the war, brewing under the radar very secretly. The war for rare earth elements. What are these elements? How do we describe them? These are certain elements which do not possess any supernatural characteristics, but they still rule the world and they rule your lives. And there is one country which is sitting on a pile of them. From smartphones to supersonic jets, these are the secret ingredients of almost every scientific wonder. Before I tell you which country is it, please take a moment to subscribe to this channel, and if you like this video, please share it forward and drop in your comments. Now, before I tell you which country, do you remember studying periodic table in your school? Didn't like it? I don't like it either. But this is important. Take a look at this. Take a look at these couple of rows. They appear to have been kicked out by the rest of the table and they sit ignored. Now, if you take a look at these 15 elements or lanthanides, these are stuck into the sixth row of this periodic table. And if you add these lanthanides with scandium and yttrium at the top, then you get what the world knows as the rare earth elements. This, my friends, is China's secret weapon. Now, you must be thinking, why am I adding rare in front of these earth elements? Because of the distribution. They're not found in some big mines or big deposits. Instead, they are much more evenly spread across different parts of the world. However, there is one country that accounts for more than one-third reserves of the total earth elements. That accounts for more than 36%, and as of today, it accounts for more than 90% of the total global production of these rare earth elements. In the China, these could be found in a number of provinces in a handful of mines. The province of Inner Mongolia, the southern province of Hunan, Fujian and Shuangxi, and the province of Xuxian. In total, these provinces account for more than 98% of the China's total production of rare earth elements. Now, you must be thinking, why does China possibly need all these rare earth elements? Let me tell you, using these rare earth elements, China manufactures a range of devices varying from speakers, Bluetooth, smartphones, supersonic jets, defense guidance system, fertilizers, everything. They all require rare earth elements. And China is the king of all these elements. China is using this as a bargaining chip or a powerful political tool to threaten the US to cut its export. And 80% of these elements used by the US are imported from China. And China's president for life, Xi Jinping, is threatening the US and is using this as a trump card in its trade war with the US. Now, the biggest question that arises is, does the world have other options? Yes, my friends, it sure does. There are several countries in the world with these earth deposits. If extracted, these could fulfill the needs of several American and European countries and also can end China's monopoly. Brazil, Canada, Australia, Vietnam, India. Yes, India was in fact one of the first countries to recognize the importance of these minerals. In fact, it was in 1950 when India had established India's Rare Earths Limited, a government-owned corporation based in the financial hub of our country, Mumbai. Well, India did have an early mover's advantage, but it somewhere got stuck around the red tape business and low interest shown by Indian entrepreneurs because of low domestic demand. That is why our country's rare earth industry remains underused. India is the world's fifth largest reserve globally. This could be found in numerous states like Andhra Pradesh, West Bengal, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Odisha, and North Indian states. Now, let me tell you, according to some estimates, this industry could potentially generate domestic supply chain of about $12 billion and capital net employment of about $16 billion. Just think about the scope of this industry. It is immense. Just think about our plan. Atmanirbharta, vocal for local. If one thing has been taught about this pandemic, it is self-reliance. That is why our country needs to come up with some strategy to use these elements to its fullest potential. Because I think this could be our chance at achieving Atmanirbharta.